happen. So we'll go with youth.
Yep. But to move on to the second fight we have on the card, a main card, which is a women's flyweight matchup between Jillian Robertson, who is 9-5 and is the +140 underdog, versus Miranda Maverick, who is 10-2 and is the -165 favorite. What's your predictions?
So again, these are two younger fighters, 25 and 23. I take age into consideration. Maverick was good in Invicta. She won a tournament there. I know the first fight I saw her in the UFC, you know, a lot of hype. You know, she's got a cool name. You know, she's got muscles. I wasn't super impressed. I feel like she's pretty solid at everything, but not great at anything. I don't know if her power will transition into the UFC, because she's not like a one punch. She has to like have a lot of volume, it looked like, from what I've seen of her. So I have Maverick by decision, because Jillian can take a lot of punishment. Jillian is tough. I've seen her fight a few times, and I'm like kind of like impressed by how much she can stay in a fight without being taken out. So I don't think Maverick has enough power to finish her, or enough volume to finish her. But I got decision for Maverick. That's where I'm going with two young. I like when two young fighters fight each other, unlike boxing. 25 versus 23 year old. This is a nice little fight. Not a pay per view fight, by the way. This should be on an undercard as well. This shouldn't be on the main card, in my opinion. But what do you have?
Yeah, this fight was the one yesterday that was moved from the prelim to the main card. I thought they should have did Menafield and Knight, right. But I can see why they added this, because they kind of wanted like a very good main event on the prelim card, which makes sense. But with this, Jillian Robertson, she fights out of American Top Team. Then you got Miranda Maverick, who fights out of the House of Muay Thai. Jillian is coming off a loss to Talia Santos, but one or two fights before that. She likes to take her opponents down to the ground, use her Brazilian jiu-jitsu to try and lock in submissions. Yep. Like, I learned a little bit about her because she was like one of my first interviews.
Yes.
When I started this podcast.
Yeah.
And she was just talking about, like, raving about Din Thomas and how great he was with teaching her. And then that's where she learns the most out of her. And she's like, and she's better in her striking, but like her mainstay is her ground and pound. Like, definitely. Her game plan with Maverick is going to be get down to the mat to keep the volume of striking to a minimum, and then to try and win by submission. She's kind of like I wouldn't say a one trick pony, but she's, everything else is improving, but she's only strong at the ground game.
Then she reminds me of Misha Tate, yes. Like a poor man's Misha Tate almost, like where, like her volume striking is okay if the person can't strike very well, and she wants to be on the ground striking with volume. So kind of like a mini Misha Tate, but we'll see if she can, ascend to that level. Yeah. This is a good stepping stone fight for her though. Like, and this is a good, good to see, where she's at, because Jillian is not a clown, you know what I mean?
Yep. Then you got Maverick, who's coming on a 6-fight winning streak. She is a good grappler with a brown belt in Brazilian jiu-jitsu and has really good striking offense. She won her debut by a knockout in the UFC. This is her second fight in the promotion. She's going to look to stand up and trade with Robertson and attempt to defend the takedowns. She's going to want to pour in as much volume, like you said, as possible, because she's going to want to inflict more damage. That's her game. Her takedown defense is unknown because she didn't have to use it in the first fight, but she would thrive if she can keep Jillian at bay. At the end of the day, I feel like Robertson's one trick pony. She hasn't really evolved yet from how long she's been in. She, the people that she's supposed to beat, she beats, and then she gets to the tougher talent where they are stronger in two backgrounds than just one.
Sure.
And I feel like she's labeled right now as a submission specialist. That's what she is.
Damian,
she can she can take people down and do that, but her striking still needs a lot of work. I feel like Maverick is stronger, more physical, and faster than Joan Robinson. So the way I see it now is I have Miranda Maverick by second round knockout. I think she's going to knock her out. I do agree that Joan Robinson can take a lot of damage.
Yeah.
And she, which is a good thing because it shows that you don't have a glass chin.
Right.
But I feel like with her wanting to get the fight to the ground, if she gets the fight to the ground, I think it's going to be close. Because then she can minimize what Maverick does, and we don't know what Maverick would do when she gets taken down. But at the end of the day, I feel like Maverick, she's going to do whatever she can to get into the center octagon,
right?
Keep the fight standing.
If
the fight's standing, Robinson has no chance.
Zero.
But if Robinson can get the fight to the ground, she'll have a chance to squeak out a decision. So she could do that, I think she can win, but I still think it's going to be Maverick by knockout.
Yeah, and that TKO was a doctor stoppage. I remember that the girl had broke her nose and should have continued. It looked ugly, but this is one of those fights I watched. I'm like, you know what? In the men's game, they would let this continue. And again, it was volume. It wasn't like that. I still have decision just because I don't know about Maverick's full power. Yeah. That stoppage was early, in my opinion, her last fight. I still think it's going it'll be decision, but we'll see if Maverick has the guts if Jillian goes down to get on top of Jillian. Because again, a submission specialist, like, you know, when Usman fights Amaya, you know, or Woodley fight Maya, like they let him, they don't want to deal with him on the ground. I think Woodley kept letting him up, you don't want to be even on top of a person that's a submission specialist.
Just look at Sterling versus Jan. Sterling was baiting him to come in, and Jan was like, nah, I'm just going to stand here and wait for you to get up.
Exactly. So we'll see if Maverick is bold enough, like a Maverick, you know what I mean? Is she bold enough if she gets her in trouble to get on top of her, or does she let her up and just piece her up on the feet? Because, again, like you said, her best option, Maverick, is to just piece her up and either get this TKO or KO or cruise to the decision on her feet, like I said. So, but we pretty much agree again.
Yep. So moving on to the third fight.